The following program originally aired at an earlier time. Enjoy.
Well, hello. Hello from Iggy Pop and The Passenger. And this is WPWL, Pauling Public Radio, 103.7. I'm Carolee Cantor with Mike Berquist and our special guest, Ed Smith, who is here to talk about a wonderful new app that I hope everybody hears, that everybody will enjoy, and hopefully you'll all apply one tonight. But I really love the song by Iggy Pop. That's great. Yes. We're going to hear it at the end of the show, too. Hi, Ed.
Hi. Thank you.
How
for
are
having,
you?
Thank
How
you
are
for
you?
Having me.
Well, thank you for being with us. And you are from Wingdale. You
yes.
live in Wingdale, and you have started a new business about 18 months ago.
Yes, it's called the Metronaut Station, and it's a mobile app geared for commuters so that it gives them a reference guide of what businesses and utilities are available near each of the stations that they're traveling through every day. Mm-hmm. Many commuters don't know what's in their own backyard, local dry cleaners, great places to eat, great mm-hmm. tourism, mm-hmm. Organizations like Lucky Orphans, which is right up here on Route 22.
And we have so many wonderful places that we can stop and visit, and your app talks about all of them.
Yes.
Which is great, and there are so many from here, and people commute every day hours.
Exactly, exactly.
Hours.
The average commuter, it's between 1 and 4 hours every day on a train.
Wow.
And at Pauling Station, we average about 1,200 commuters daily coming on and off the train.
Really? Wow. Wow. Where do they like to go?
Sometimes they just jump off the train, right into their car, and go left or right. They never change their pattern unless there's a detour. Then they stumble across something that's been in their backyard all this time and say, oh, how long have you been here? Great new business, and the business has been there for 20 years. So they're really just discovering, unless yes. they make a wrong turn. They don't discover what's been in their backyard all this time, like yeah. the local dry cleaners, the local pizza, bakery shops, everything.
That's wonderful. So just so nice to have you. And you've actually designed this to, let me just repeat again,
sure.
you've designed this brand new mobile app for commuters that helps commuters learn all about the businesses in the many villages along the railroad line.
Yes.
The app also has information about ticketing and schedules, which can be purchased online at www.metronorthstation.com. Since 1984, Ed has been working on media guides for this area.
Yes.
So you've been in this, doing this a long time.
Yes, web design, web hosting.
And you know the area very well.
Yes.
You are the man to talk to. Definitely the man to talk to. I've been here 42 years, and I still don't know this area, so I am definitely going to ask you how to apply the app later.
Sure, we'll install it on your phone.
Yeah, I'd love to do that. I'd love to do this. But this knowledge is marvelous for commuters as well as local businesses. More businesses have been contacted by people since your app has come into play about 18 months now.
Yes, each business that advertises, we don't just place a banner ad. We put their full brochure, their full restaurant menu.
Uh-huh.
If they're a DJ, we put their music right on the
wow.
app so people can experience it.
Wow, it's marvelous what you can do with your phone today. It's a wonderful thing. So we're going to really enjoy using it and enjoying our area.
Yes.
And enjoy all the ways along the area, all the way to New York City, and from New York City all the way back here,
mm-hmm.
and up to Dover, Wasaic.
It goes up to Wasaic, up to
Poughkeepsie,
and New Haven, the New Haven line.
There's like four different lines.
Four different lines.
Yeah, and all along those lines are places that a lot of us have not seen.
Some people don't even know the towns that are nearby. There's 144 stations on the Metro North.
Can you believe that? 144. Well, that sounds like a bucket list of things.
Oh, definitely.
To do, you know. just to visit along that. And I believe there's a Danbury line, too.
Yes, Danbury line. So. And then right south of there is another town, Bethel, which is a great arts and crafts and restaurant village that most people don't even know exists.
I know. I went to visit the little railroad museum at Danbury.
Yes, they're one of our clients.
Yeah. Oh, really?
Yes.
They're wonderful.
Yes, Wade is excellent and knowledgeable. And we donated their advertisement on our app just to share the knowledge of what's out there for the railroads, because he's trying to preserve everything that's happening with the railroads.
That's an amazing museum to visit.
Yes,
It's not just the outdoor museum, mm-hmm. but indoors there's an informational center, like a little museum that you can...
Yes, and in fact there are a lot of people that schedule to have weddings there because they just want to have the 1920s trolley cars that are there.
So that's only one of the many, many beautiful places that we have here.
Oh, yes.
So how did you get the idea for this app?
Basically, I've been a technology consultant for decades now, and I've always traveled through the local train system, especially if you're going into Manhattan. It's the quickest and easiest way to get from downtown to Dutchess and Westchester County. And most of my clients tended to be along the rails. So when... About the last decade, there really started to be a trend growing. And I actually reserved the name 10 years ago.
Really?
Because I was originally going to make a website for it, but the technology hadn't caught up to what I had envisioned. And now with mobile technology, it's at the perfect fulcrum point. Most of these businesses along the rails, they started having difficulty because local newspapers would shut down. Coverage of local penny saver type magazines also shrunk down because of the cost of printing was so high. So because of that, they became disconnected. So these communities had so many family-owned businesses that had no way of reaching new customers or even their existing customers to let them know they're having a special going on. So I had developed this to kind of connect the thousands of commuters that still don't know what's in their backyard with the thousands of businesses along the rails that are walking distance or short driving distance, so that it can help stimulate the commerce, bringing the customers to them, and also providing necessary services that they don't realize are in their backyards. I know people personally in Wingdale that drive all the way up to Poughkeepsie for dry cleaning.
Wow.
Because they just don't have any other knowledge. They go out to New Milford. They go down to Danbury because they just know, go to the mall, there's one in the mall. But we have Edison Cleaners right here around the corner. And he's one of our advertisers, and we promote them through the train. So I believe in stimulating and supporting the local businesses, because that's what grew our villages. Were actually, when the trains came up, they stopped at a certain point. That became a village, and all the businesses around there supported the people who were going on and off the train. So I'm just trying to resurge that using the current technology.
That's marvelous. And when you think about Pauling Village, what you find when you get off the train here.
Exactly.
There's so much, right? Just think about Pauling by itself. There's so many wonderful things, and people don't know about them.
They don't know about the farmer's market that's right out here on the weekends. The bakery right here, Vinny's Deli. That's been on the Food Network. They might not know that he's here because they don't come to the side of the track when they get in their car. The Village Pizza that just opened up. Lavender Shop. There's so many nice businesses in the area. The Meat and Hook that's right around the corner, where you can get all kinds of...
the bakeria here.
The bakeria as well.
And Pauling Public Radio.
Exactly.
Pauling Public Radio is right here.
Exactly, right in the heart of it. And all these villages, it's a way of giving them a guide for it. And even with Pauling Public Radio, we've embedded you on our app. So they can listen to these broadcasts whenever they're on the rails.
Well, that'll be wonderful, you know, for people to be able to listen to our station all day, you know, as they're commuting.
Back and forth. They don't have to wait till they're out of the signal from the towers. They can take it all the way. I took it personally down to White Plains on Friday.
Oh, really?
I traveled with my wife, and I said, I'm going to test this before we go on the air. And I streamed your broadcast all the way down to White Plains when we went down this weekend.
That's wonderful. So your wife is Giselle?
Yes, Giselle.
And does she works with you in the business?
Yes, she does.
And you have two
children, Lewis and Sheena. And they're completely away from technology as can be.
Okay, that's all right.
They're in their own routes right now.
That's okay.
And I have a few people that work with me closely. Rick DeFord, he's been with me for years now from the beginning of this.
Right.
Kyle Finelli, David Dow, Desmond Volzer.
They all live in the area.
They all live in the area.
Oh, great.
And they're from different backgrounds.
Yeah.
And it becomes useful because they could approach different clientele. It's everybody from a 25-year-old to a 60-year-old.
Yeah, I was going to ask you who's utilizing the app now. You said you have a lot of...
we have...
A million? Did I read a million?
Yes, we hit...
I must be mistaken. A million? Wow.
We hit 1 million one million commuters using our app in May of 2016.
Wow. More power to you. That's
so
wonderful.
It serves a need and a niche that the commuters are jumping in from their cars to the train, and they don't really have any time.
Yeah.
But when they're on the train, there's nothing to do for that whole commute.
Yeah.
So this lets them plan what they're going to do when they get back, where they can order dinner from the app on the way home and pick it up, and instead of jumping out the car, waiting for it to be cooked, and then pick it up. So it's streamlined everything. And it allows the local merchants to let them know Restaurant Week just came out.
Yes, that I think you're promoting Restaurant Week. A good deal. You want to talk a little bit?
Sure.
Everybody has to get involved with Restaurant Week.
Definitely.
It's so exciting.
Restaurant Week is an ideal opportunity because it allows people from outside our area to come and try what's in Pauling, what's there to eat, local places, whether it's McGrath's, come to Vinny's Deli for the steak margarita,
Kenny and Doyle.
I mean, you come out, and Restaurant Week is a great week because it encourages people from outside the area to travel and try what's in these different towns.
Right.
And once they do that, then they discover other things that Pauling has to offer, and that's what brings in the commerce, and that's what we have to do, and that's what supports the mom-and-pop businesses, the local businesses.
Well, Good Tidings is a beautiful gift shop, and our Book Cove is a wonderful bookstore.
And definitely. And it's a sidewalk community where they can park the car and take a stroll, and if they're here on the weekends, too, there's the farmer's market that comes when the weather gets nice. Grab a pastry from the bakeria. I mean, there's so many
things. Have you ever done it, Anoui?
Yes.
While you're waiting?
Yes, exactly. So, I mean, there's so much to offer that they might not have taken the time to find and discover what's in each of these towns.
Yeah.
So that's what one of the goals with the app is. Since a majority of my clients are local family-owned businesses, my goal with this was to help support them so that they don't shut down and it just becomes a mall complex. Because I grew up having a deli, a butcher, a bakery.
So did I.
There's a fresh bakery just opened up here as well. These are what every community needs, and that's what keeps people in the community. So it doesn't become a bedroom community where people don't have to drive an hour to get dry cleaning or a pizza.
Right. We had a little discussion before we went on today, and I said, what happens in case of an emergency? You find yourself, you land in a village, you're stuck. You can't reach your husband, you can't reach your children, you can't get any transportation. What do you do?
The app has a safety feature built into it. I developed this about 6 months ago. Before the bad weather came in. And what typically happens with most commuters is they will go down to Manhattan to see a Broadway show. They come back up. Their car's been sitting in the cold for numerous
that's
hours.
Another scenario, right.
It doesn't start when they get back here.
Yeah.
And most train stations, unless you're in a village station like Pauling, there really isn't too many local places you could just walk and ask for help. So if you're stranded at Southeast, which is a big station that a lot of people get stranded at, the app has an emergency call button, which is programmed to contact the local tow truck that's in that vicinity to come and help you.
Oh, that's fabulous.
So that you don't have to wait for somebody to be dispatched from White Plains or Poughkeepsie, where it's an hour or so wait. They actually support the local business, the local tow truck that services that station anyway, and it just connects that commuter in that time of need directly with them. And when you're north of White Plains or Westchester area, the Dutchess operates a little different. The fire departments are on volunteer status.
Yes.
You have a sheriff's office versus NYPD. Mm-hmm. So up here, being that it operates a little different, we put in the local numbers for the local authorities.
Right.
So in case something happens and they have to call the police, instead of going into 911 where they get dispatched, 911 is coded into the app anyway.
Yeah.
But if they just need to get in touch with the local sheriff because there's a loose dog, they don't have to go through the 911 sequence.
Right.
They can, if they need to call the local tow truck, they just click a button and it's right there.
I just want to remind people that they're listening to Community Focus. We're here with this very special guest, Ed Smith, from his marvelous Metro North app. And we're so pleased to have you tonight, Ed.
Thank you. It's a pleasure
and
to
Mike,
be here.
And Mike, thank you again. PaulinePublicRadio.org, streaming from your computer, 103.7. Now we're going to continue. If I would like to install this app.
Yes.
How easy is it?
It's very easy. It's very easy. We set up our website to be very user-friendly, so it's very quick and easy to download or to install it on you. And I'll
yeah, I just so happen to have my cell phone here.
Well, what I'll do is I'll show you exactly how to install it.
Okay.
Open up Safari. This is an upper.
Yeah, what do I do?
This is for an iPhone. So on an iPhone, you open up Safari.
Okay.
And you go to our website, Metro North.
Metro North. What?
Station.
Okay. At the app. You go to the app.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
And then once it's up.
Right.
The middle button, right above your round button mm-hmm. on your iPhone, you just hit that.
Oh my goodness.
Add.
Huh.
And hit add up on top.
You just add it.
That's it. It's done.
And look how beautiful it looks. It's going to look gorgeous when it gets when it comes up on my phone.
Let's see. There it is.
Look at that. It's beautiful. It says www.metronorthstation.com. Mm-hmm. Metro North Station, taxi services, places to eat, local shopping, your guide to riding the trails. Tell us about your guide to riding the trails.
Okay. Well, the reason why I use that catchphrase is because I'm trying to encourage people to deal with the local businesses, uh-huh. deal with the local farmers, the local charities. Uh-huh. It's very easy to write a check for a charity you've never met, but there are plenty of local ones. Like, mm-hmm. for example, Lucky Orphans right here in Dover Plains.
Uh-huh.
They have a horse rescue.
Uh-huh.
It's a wonderful charity. And mm-hmm. if you click on our app, there's actually streaming video that talks all about the charity. They've
goodness.
Partnered with the Hudson Heroes, which mm-hmm. is for veterans suffering from PTSD, which they have a horse therapy program.
Yeah. Oh, that's great.
So, I mean, there's
now,
so many.
Who knows about that?
There's so many wonderful programs like that that.
They don't know. People don't know that.
That they don't come across. So, this guide, part of being the guide to your businesses along the rails, is actually letting people know what's available, what's in the area. Maybe even if you want to just go up to, let's say, Danbury.
Yeah.
Where's a local. The Danbury Museum. You'll discover the Danbury Railroad Museum.
Right.
Their full brochure, all the information about how to reach it.
Right.
And all the material that's built into the app is made to be interactive. So we stream video, we stream audio, we link everything into the client's mm-hmm. websites, mm-hmm. their social media, everything mm-hmm. is there. So it's a one-stop guide just for that particular business.
That's marvelous. It also says, read today's news.
Yes.
Visit our virtual
newsstand.
That sounds nice. I always like to hear current news.
Exactly.
So you can get today's news from several, I see you have several papers there.
Yes.
Oh. Excuse me.
It's the curse of cell phones.
That's right.
So if you go to a virtual newsstand, you have a choice. You could have the Daily News, Wall Street Journal, New York Post, the Poughkeepsie Journal, Bronx Times, AM. We have Westchester Magazine. The Gotham Gazette, all the popular.
And you can read them all on the app.
You can read them all on the app. So if you hit the New Yorker or.
Goodbye, little duffel bag.
Yes.
I can just have just my little cell phone.
Or like what never happened before. Or some years ago, you used to just walk up and down the aisle and there were 30, 40 newspapers left over and being disposed.
Right.
Today, you can't even find a newspaper on the trains when you travel. So now you have, and if you didn't have time to grab a paper on the way to the train because you were worried about missing that connection,
mm-hmm.
now you have your newspaper in the palm of your hand as well.
That's amazing. This is so nice. You just touch it and there it is.
Yes.
And the whole world's open to you here along the trail.
And it's user-friendly. Nice. You could even sign up for notifications. So,
Very attractive.
Thank you. For example, with Restaurant Week coming out, all of our advertisers that have specials and they send it to us, we send it to our email subscription list. On the app, we have 215,000 commuters have subscribed to our service.
Oh, my God.
So we blast weekly. What's going on in the areas, what's going on in the towns, and it's a great way of connecting people with business.
And I see it says your business on this app.
Yes.
So it says there are advertisement rates for businesses that are interested in coming on the app, which is nice.
Yes.
And how many businesses do you have here already?
Right now we have 457.
457 businesses.
As of last week.
That is fabulous.
And part of our goal was also to make it affordable for businesses of any size.
Right.
Whether you're the local candy store or you have the local large-scale restaurant.
Well, this is wonderful.
And we kept the price very reasonable. It's $200 for an entire year.
Oh,
they put their entire brochure in. They could change the material throughout the year. We put their videos, we put their audio, whatever materials they have. We try to give them the best representation of their business on the app to encourage people to keep using it and going back and forth to their business as well.
That's fantastic. It's a wonderful opportunity for the businesses to increase their patronage. Now I see you say join our free membership and receive email notifications.
Yes. Yes, so this way, especially when the holidays come around, everybody has Christmas specials.
Uh-huh.
For example, Mother's Day is coming up, so there's plenty of places that make chocolate and bakeries, and don't
push
forget
the
mom.
Chocolate.
Push the chocolate.
Push the chocolate.
especially for Easter, everybody is shooting. We just did Samuel's Sweet Shop up in Rhinebeck.
They're
off the Poughkeepsie line.
Yeah.
And a nice artisan craft shop.
I mean,
you wouldn't know it was there unless you happened to venture that direction.
That is this is so wonderful. You are in a happy business.
Yes, yes, definitely.
You're in a very happy business.
And we deal with business a little differently. I feel a lot of businesses have gone completely technology-sided, and they're cold. They want to email, leave voicemail. They don't want to talk to you. We make a point of going out into the town and introducing ourselves to local businesses and talking with them, because we can't help that business unless we visited that business and kind of talk with the people.
Right.
So
let's leave your phone number in case
anybody
wants to call you. How would people reach you?
They could reach me at www.metronorthstation.com.
Okay.
My email address is edsmith@metronorthstation.com, and our toll-free number is 800-396-5281. They can call anytime, and we would love to go out and visit a business on site and introduce ourselves and find out more about what their business is, so we can represent them the best way on the app.
All right. Well, this sounds really, really marvelous. And you're located in Wasaic?
In Wasaic is our business address.
200, Route 22.
Yes, Route 22.
This is called Route 22 Computers.
Yes, that's the main corporation.
And I believe, also from our conversation, that you teach computers in your studio.
Yes, we do. And we provide on-site service now, because we found that works better. We could teach your staff on your equipment, and this way everybody's familiar, instead of having a classroom setting where everything's perfect. We'll come on site.
Wow.
And we have several seniors that we've instructed classes to. The oldest student we have is 96 years old.
Whoa. So I still have a chance.
Yeah, definitely.
That's
definitely.
Great.
You would be surprised at the age range. We do from 4 years to 96.
Yeah, that's really terrific. That's really, and so needed.
Yes.
And so needed, because this area can be very isolating.
Oh, definitely.
Technologically.
Definitely.
So it's wonderful that this is starting, so people are at least have an abridgment to the world.
Exactly. And then if you get stranded with your phone, it's more than playing a Pokemon game. They could actually find something, get help, or even watch videos on it, because most of the businesses today have some sort of video commercial, and we embed those in there, too. So you can find out about local organizations, a lot of information on there.
Well, Mr. Ed Smith, I want to thank you so much for being our guest tonight. This has been a revelation for us all. I'm hoping you'll come back in a couple of months, and tell us more, that now you have even more people involved and more businesses, because I just think the future sounds so bright for this.
Thank you for having me. We're constantly evolving the app. I'd love to return in a couple months and let you know what we've evolved and
thank you, Ed.
Features we've added.
Thank you. And thank you for being a good friend to Pauling Public Radio. We really appreciate it.
I believe in supporting the local business, and I'm glad to have you. Welcome aboard on our app as well.
We're all aboard.
Exactly. And we're streaming on our app as we speak now. So
great.
There are people on the train listening to this broadcast.
Oh, hello, everybody. maybe they'd like to hear a little more of Iggy Pop's Passenger.
Exactly.
All right. Shall we play some Passenger, Mike Berquist? Thank you so much. Signing off.
Good night.
Good night.